This is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We have an exciting garden update today. So about 2 weeks ago, I had a special offer for people to come do a personal and private garden tour here at my house to check out what I'm growing. And there are several people that took advantage of that. And it starts today at 2:30, and we have Jaime over here with me. And Jaime's going to get the one and only first time ever personal garden tour from like anybody other than, you know, my close friends to come over to see my place. I really want to keep this kind of private for obvious reasons, you know, but he's signed up and got the special deal, and he's going to get the personal tour with me to see what I'm growing and how I'm doing it, and you guys are going to get to come along with us. All right, so we're here in the front of my front yard garden here with Jaime, and I was talking with Jaime, and he basically said he's really interested in some of that diversity that I grow and some of the different crops that I grow that's not so common. I guess he originally found me through searching on YouTube about raised bed construction, so that was really cool. It's always fun to find out how people find me. So all the viewers out there, please post below and let me know how you found me originally. I'm really curious on knowing, so that's going to be really cool. But we're going to first talk about this plant running up my arbor trellis thing in the entryway. And if you saw my other shows, you saw when we planted these guys, and these are scarlet runner beans. And so the reason why I like these beans is that they're basically Native American heirloom beans. And when you actually open a pod up, and this pod is getting really big, and I see lots of aphids on here. And I don't have that problem until they get really big, actually. But this is the scarlet runner bean. And at this stage, it's really tough to eat the outside shell. But take a look at these beans on the inside. They are amazing colors. Oh, they're getting pretty small. They're still pretty small. But they get like just all kinds of stripes and stuff on them. Want to try that?
Sure. I didn't know you could eat these. I thought they were just for decoration. And that's why I planted them.
Oh, I see. Garden. So he grew these for decoration. These beans, I normally don't eat them at this stage. They're edible. I'm not a big fan of eating beans raw. They probably should be cooked. That being said, this is the older stage. And if you try to eat them... Oh, the shell's still not too bad, actually. You can try that shell. What do you think?
It's good to eat.
It's sweet. Yeah. Now, try one of these younger ones. Now, this is the stage I really like to get them. This is when they're really edible, raw, and really delicious. They have a nice, sweet flavor. So, I want you to try that one.
The big one. A sugar snap. Sorry.
Yes. Thank you. Yeah. So, that's like as sweet as a sugar snap pea, and this is a runner bean, and it just flourishes in the summertime, in the heat, when, you know, sugar snaps might not do too well in the hot weather. And these things will take over. I mean, we started with small plants. We have six per side, and it's filled up my trellis here, and it's growing up through the top now. It's pretty amazing. The other thing is you can eat the small leaves. And I'm not going to feed you any because they're actually not too tasty, but I have heard they are also edible. I don't really recommend it. For me, it would be a famine food. I might occasionally snag a leaf to eat. But what is really good and really delicious are these flowers. Take a look at these flowers here. These flowers, if they're still closed, they're edible, but they're even better when they're open. And a lot of the different birds basically love the flowers and the pollen. And I see an ant on this one, so I'm going to blow it off. Well, that's really good.
And I learned that from you on a previous video. Eating the flowers, that's where I got it from.
Oh, cool. Yeah, and what do you think of that flower?
They're all sweet, yeah.
Yeah, so like... This is a really good crop to grow in the summertime. You know, all edible, small leaves, small beans, and flowers. When the beans get bigger, you know, sometimes the shell gets a lot harder, and they're not so good to eat. So here's a scarlet runner bean, and this is not totally mature yet, but you can see, check out the color, man, that purple color and the pinkish color. And I wouldn't normally eat these raw, but I'm going to try it. And I don't recommend eating them. We'll go to this bed. This bed's a little more fun. I have a couple different basils here, different varieties, but this is a really cool basil. I was told this is a perennial basil.
It looks like it really, doesn't it?
And it looks really pretty, too. Yeah, because it's not going to flower yet. And, I mean, many of the other counterparts around it are. And so we'll see what happens. And it's actually called a pesto. Try to have tags. Pesto perpetuo basil. So perpetuo meaning... perennial or perpetual, keeps growing. That one's really cool in this bed. This one's really cool. This one's called Let me break this leaf off in half there. This one's not really an herb, but I put it in my herb bed. And this one's called Roselle. Ooh. And it's a hibiscus sabbardifina. So it's a red stem tangy vegetable. And this, once again, is a tropical. It'll grow year-round unless it freezes like in Florida. I brought plants back from when I went to Echo out there in Florida. And it's really good. It has a sorrel-y flavor.
Yeah.
I think this one also likes a little bit more humidity. You can kind of see this. There's some kind of like the leaf curl. I think that's what happens when it gets a little bit too cold for it. But I have two of them there. Let's see. The next one that's really cool in this bed is this guy. Have you ever had fresh Go-To Cola?
No.
So this is fresh Go-To Cola here. Go-To Cola is sold oftentimes in the supplement store, as a good memory tonic or memory herb. Has a really kind of stronger flavor, so you wouldn't want to like totally eat a lot of it, but I like to add some to my green smoothie and get the benefits of that.
Yeah.
It's fun. One time I was in Costa Rica at walking over the rainforest, and I saw just a bunch of that growing, and I knew what it was because I had grown it. And so I just stopped and ate a whole bunch of it. Let's see. So I got lemon verbena, another common one. But the one next to it is really cool. I forget the exact name. I know it's called Rao Ram. And it's another tropical. It actually likes to stay fairly wet. And that's this guy right here. We can pinch the tops off. Yeah, this guy's a lemon verbena.
Oh, yeah.
Not the same
stuff.
Okay.
I tried
same
this
stuff
at the, I think maybe at the Vietnamese market or something.
Yeah, I think it's called Vietnamese coriander.
That is good.
Yeah, that's good stuff. So this definitely doesn't like to freeze, and it's good, grows really well. And when my cilantro next to it's flowering, and going to be ending, this will just continue to grow. So I'm going to try to, some of these plants, when it does get colder, I'm going to try to just dig up the root balls, just transfer them in a 3 or 5 gallon. We'll take them in the greenhouse and see if we could keep them alive through the winter, just in an unheated greenhouse. There's one other thing in here that was really cool, and I was eating it the other day. So I went to an herb fair, and I did an episode on that. It was a Sebastopol herb fair. And I asked a lady at this place, Morning Sun Herb Farm, in Vacaville, California, about what's a cool edible leaf green that you could just grow and eat. And she told me this one. It's called Touch of Spice. It's called Sideritis, and it's from Israel. And she said this is really rare, and you could eat it. And so I said, okay. So let me see, and I bought a plant, make sure I'm getting it right, and it's this plant right here, it was flowering earlier, but try that leaf here, tell me what you think. You got some?
I think my tongue's going numb.
Really?
From like all the different things.
No.
Yeah.
I know when I tasted it the other day, I'm like, wow, that's a really unique and exotic taste. And I liked it. I don't know what
yeah,
you guys...
Yeah, it's got a lot of different flavors.
Yeah, that's why it's called this, a spice plant. Or whatever
yeah,
it's called. I don't even know. I mean, I did a little bit of research about it, but
it's
really
like
unique.
Many different flavors to it.
Yeah. So, like, yeah, otherwise I just have other more common things in here. This back along the garage, I have a trellis, which is grapes. And many people say you need to have full sun for grapes.
Yeah.
But, maybe for optimal production, you need full sun. But as you can see, I have, a bunch of grapes. I don't know if I could have more in full sun. And I probably should, clip back the bunches that are too close and stuff. But this thing grows like crazy. We made another bed here where I have artichokes that are about the point and beyond the point to harvest. And once again, they're doing fairly good in full sun. This is their first year.
And what do you do with those?
Eat them raw.
Okay.
I'll have a video on that soon. I've been
Probably
when I harvest these. I'm just going to, I cut them off.
Mm-hmm.
And actually, once you pick the artichoke in the store and it starts to dry out, or even at the farmer's market starts to dry out, then it gets a lot more hard and woody. But if you just chop it off and bring it inside and take it apart and eat it just like you, as if you boiled it, it's actually a lot softer and easier to eat.
Mm.
And then just like you eat it cooked, I'd eat it raw. So I'd strip off the first bottom lower layers. Then I'd have, some of these. Why don't we just pop this one off now and you guys can try it. So what I'd do is I'd just come down, and they got thorns on them, obviously. I'd come down and I'd strip off all the lower ones, and there are some aphids and ants on here, so just be aware of that.
Need it raw.
You get a small, like a totally small bite.
Can I try one?
Yo, yeah, we're coming.
Cool. Thank you.
But yeah, I mean, there's that like white parts. It's good. It's crunchy. I mean, it's a lot of work to get a little bit, but.
Well, it is if you cook them too.
Yeah.
That's good.
But yeah, so I'll do that. Obviously, the outer leaves are just too tough to eat. But the inner ones, and then you just go all the way, and then you just do the same thing with the heart, scoop out all that fuzzy stuff, clip it down, shave this off, and you can eat that raw as well. Yeah, it's easy to and delicious to eat an artichoke raw.
Yeah.